Hey kids, today we're going to make a Christmas stocking. First, find a stocking that you like, a pattern that you like. You can find a couple online, but basically just take it and get a big piece of paper and draw around the stocking that you like, unless you find the pattern online somewhere. Make sure you draw the pattern about a quarter of an inch bigger than the actual stocking that you want to do. I've already got my pattern piece cut out. But what you're going to do is you're going to need a piece of focus fabric, which is that poinsettia, and a piece of lining fabric, and it's doubled up. And what you want to do is you want to cut them out together, because that way they'll be the same size. So what I do is I put them on top of one another, then I go ahead and I pin the stocking to all four pieces of the fabric, and I cut it out. Then you're going to save that little piece that comes out there in the very corner, because what you want to do is we want to make the hanger. And I try to make mine about 2 inches by 6 inches. And you don't have to have a rotary cutter and a ruler. You can go ahead and just kind of eyeball it. But since I have it, that's what I use. And right now I am cutting the 2x6, and the wind... Occasionally you will see my the cat from my camera, and there's my cat trying to pull the fabric that's flying around. She loves to be interactive when I am making my sewing creations. But here we go. We have a 2x6 inch piece of fabric, and what we're going to do is we're going to fold it in half. And then just, you know, place firm pressure on it, because what you want to do is you want to see that line. Then you're going to take each end and fold it in towards the middle of that line. And what you're going to end up with is 1/4 of the size of what you cut out. So both sides come in, and then you close it up. And since I'm going to be using it later, I usually just pin it to hold it together. And then I just put it on the side. And that will be the hanger for our stocking. So that will come into play later. There we go. We've got out the sewing machine, and I'm showing you here that's the you know, the pieces have turned in, and you're just gonna sew right up the one side where they, you know, where they come together. And it's just as simple as that. Take it off, cut it, and put it on the side, because we're gonna use it later on in the you know, stocking making situation. Now we have all four pieces of the fabric, and what you want to do is you want to take the focus fabric, and you want to make sure that both of the right sides are facing each other, so that the wrong sides are facing out. Then you're going to go ahead, you're going to put it into the sewing machine, and you're going to use the width of the foot. So the edge of the foot is going to be my guideline. That's why I don't use pins, but if you're you know, you're a beginner, you can go ahead and pin the entire stocking together. But I'm just using the force at this point because I've made so many of them. And I just use the outside foot as my guide, so that all my seams are the same length and width and all that fun stuff. And I'm using a different program, so I'm not quite sure how to speed things up and whatnot, so I'm just going to have to talk to you while this entire thing plays out in its entirety. And there we go. We finish up, cut up all your strings. And what we're going to do at this point is we're going to clip. We're going to make tiny little clips. Now make sure you do not cut your thread when you're going through. So make sure that you know, it's shorter than the seams, because if you cut your thread, then you're going to have to go ahead and re-sew. You'll create a hole in your stocking. But the reason for making these clips is so that when you turn the stocking inside out, it looks like a stocking and it's not pulling. It's just, you know, giving a little bit of ease. And I do it from the beginning part of just be on top of where the arch of the foot would be until right about where the Achilles, you know, and your heel part is in the back. And perhaps about every half inch, I make a tiny little a little cut. Then I put my hand all the way through, grasp it at the end, and I pull it all the way through. Then I go ahead and I put my hand back in and I push at the seams to make sure that everything comes out nice and flat and really pretty, like a stocking, you know, should look. Some people like to use like crochet needles, something without a sharp edge, and to make it, you know, look nicely. Now what I'm doing is the lining part. At the lining, what you want to do is you want to leave an opening of about maybe 2 or 3 inches. So I went ahead, I did a couple of inches in, and I backspaced to make sure, you know, when we turn things in and out, that it doesn't, you know, the thread doesn't pull apart. And then I cut the thread, I went another 2 or 3 inches down, I went forward and backwards a little bit again, and now we're going to go ahead and finish up the complete stocking, around, you know, all the way around the stocking, using the same outside edge of the stocking as the guide. And what we did was we created a little hole on the side there so that we can turn the stocking inside out. Then we're going to go ahead and we're going to close up that seam a little bit later. I will tell you when. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing again. You're going to go around about, you know, every half inch or so, and you're going to clip. Now, with the right sides facing one another, we're going to take that focus fabric, the nice, you know, one that's going to be on the outside, and we are going to stick it inside the lining fabric with the right side in and the outside on facing us on the outside. So basically the outside that's going to be showing are both facing one another. Then at the seam, what we're going to do is we're going to, you know, make sure that the seams of each side of the stocking match one another, and we're going to pin it. Then we're going to take the hanger that we made, and we're going to fold it in half, and we're going to stick it right behind the seam that we just pinned together, and we're going to pin that in place as well. Then we're going to go ahead and we are going to pin around the entire stocking. This is where you need to be, you know, really careful that everything meets up, and it should if you used, you know, the outside of your foot as a guide. Everything should match up perfectly and you shouldn't have any extra fabric on either one of these. Now, if you have a nifty sewing machine like I do, I take out that section there so that I can do circular stuff. If you don't, you just have to go very slow and make sure that you don't sew over the other half of your stocking. Now, I usually start about 2 inches before the hanger. And because the hanger and plus the stockings is a little thick, I always stick my hand through and I help guide it right over that really, you know, extra bits of material. And then just go for it. Go all the way around the entire stocking, sewing everything together nice and tightly. Once the sides meet, I usually go maybe a half an inch over. You can reverse and make sure that everything is nice and tight. Go ahead and unpin it, and then this is where we're going to make the magic happen. Remember that seam that we left open, that, you know, 2-inch seam there? I'm going to show it to you right there. You're going to start pulling everything out that's inside there. So you can pull out your focus fabric, and then once that's all entirely out, then you can start turning the lining fabric in on itself. And there you go. I'm going very slow. I just had surgery on both of my hands, so I just take things a little slower than I normally do. Otherwise, I would just be going for it. There we go. Once it's out, you can make sure that that stocking, once again, you know, you can use whatever you use to make sure that the stocking is nicely set. And there you go. You have one huge stocking like that. That's what you end up with. Then, very slowly, there's the opening right there. what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to close that opening. So take it back over to the sewing machine, and we're going to make sure that all the seams are inside and nice, and we're going to sew right over the edges. So the sewing will be showing, however, since that's the inside, the lining of your stocking, no one will ever see it. So you go ahead and then you slowly start tucking the lining inside by opening it up and slowly moving it in. Once you have it far enough in, you can go ahead and use your hand to just shove it in, and once it's all the way in, you can, you know, feel the edges and make sure that they both line up on the inside. And now you've got your stocking is almost complete. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I don't know how to fast forward. I'm sorry, guys. So, once you have everything already in there, go ahead and make sure your hanger is there. Even up the fabric so that, you know, it's nice and tidy. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to over-sew it on the top. Put it back around. Make sure that the sides of the fabric match one another. And go all the way around and complete it just the way you did when we were on the inside with all the insides showing. Once that's done, you're done. You're completely done. And you have a wonderful, beautiful stocking for your loved ones. Now, if you're not as ambitious and you don't want to do that, I make them and I sell them, and the proceeds all go to help people on YouTube who just need a tiny little bit of help during the holidays, either, you know, to help pay for their Thanksgiving meal or their Christmas meal. Or this year we're trying to strive for helping to get people, you know, that have larger families and are out of work, a couple of gifts, and I think it's a wonderful project that we call Project Love. I will leave the website down in the description box, and you can see all the stockings that are available. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed.